Hi everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel. And today in this video we will see what to do if you are receiving someone else iMessage or FaceTime call in your iPhone. Now this generally happens when you are using someone else Apple ID in your iPhone. Apple ID should be unique in each phone. You should not share your Apple ID with someone else, or you should not use someone else Apple ID in your iPhone. Now if you want to make sure what Apple ID is used in your iPhone, what we will do is we will go to settings. Here you can see the name on the top here. Tap on it, you will see there is an email ID here. This email ID is the Apple ID which is used in your iPhone. So make sure that this Apple ID which is used should be your own Apple ID and not someone else. Similarly, if I go to iTunes and App Store, here also I can see the Apple ID. So this also should be your own Apple ID. Now suppose if you have used someone else Apple ID, what you have to do is you have to go back, you have to sign out from here, then you have to enter the password for the Apple ID. Now if this is not your Apple ID, you cannot enter the password, so you have to ask the person to put the password whose Apple ID you have used in your iPhone. And once you sign out of the Apple ID of the other person, you have to sign in again with your own Apple ID. Now the other thing what you have to check is you have to go to settings, go to messages. Now if you have activated iMessage in your iPhone, you go to this option send and receive. Now once you go here, the Apple ID at the top should be yours, this phone number which is here should be your, and the email which is here should be your own email address. So you will be receiving iMessages either in the phone number or in this email ID. If you have used someone else's email ID, then you might receive the iMessage of that person in your iPhone. Similarly, if you are receiving FaceTime call of another person in your iPhone, then what you should do is you should go to settings, scroll down, and under these messages you will see FaceTime option. Since I don't have FaceTime in my iPhone, so I can't show you, but the method for disabling this iMessage and FaceTime is same. Suppose if this is FaceTime option instead of messages, you go to this option here, and again under this send and receive, you have to check this number here and this email ID or the Apple ID belongs to you only. So once you make sure that this Apple ID, the phone number is same, then you should not receive someone else iMessage or FaceTime call in your iPhone. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and share this video if you found it helpful. Also click on the subscribe button and hit on the bell icon to get the notification of our latest videos for free.